Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're on a red-hot sturgeon bite on the Willamette River near downtown Portland. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. Today we've launched in the Columbia River, but we will actually be entering the mouth of the Willamette River for a morning of catch-and-release sturgeon fishing, not far from downtown Portland, Oregon. We're with guide Bill Green, Doug Hayes of Oregon Tackle, and Dmitry Karmanov and his friend Paul Uminski. You might remember Dmitry from a previous episode from the Kaham River in Russian Siberia. Dmitry builds Kaham boats to handle the region's extreme rivers, and it was on this trip that we were able to catch our first Taimain salmon. Now, Dmitry is visiting Portland, where hopefully he will catch his first sturgeon, which in the Willamette is almost a sure thing.
We're just going to fish about 80 feet here at the Toyota hole. Pretty easy spot to anchor up, kind of popular.
So we're located here in St. John's, Oregon. This here is the St. John's Bridge. We're in about 80 feet of water. What we're doing is we're letting our anchor down to the bottom. We're going to go back just a little bit so the hooks on that anchor hold real well, and then we're going to deploy a ball. In case a ship goes by or something like that, it'll keep us from getting the front end of our hook sucked under. This river is not too bad to anchor up on, but some of the other local rivers with lots of current can be real dangerous. So anybody that wants to try this should go out with a guide or something firsthand before they do it on their own. So running autopilot, a Garmin system on my boat, what I do when I'm on anchor, especially in the Willamette River because there's not a lot of current, I'll put the motor in reverse. The autopilot has a setting on it where you can run it in reverse also. What it'll do is hold us straight. These sturgeon don't like anything that's moving around at all, so gotta keep the boat and everything and bait just as straight as we can keep it. So we're using some fresh frozen squid here. I just buy this at the local supermarket. It's really nothing special. I kind of like them when they're still a little bit frozen. That way when they melt, they kind of get that scent coming out of them. What I do is just a 4-aught hook, come through a kind of an angle, and then just thread it down. Two loops in it usually is sufficient. Come through that a second time. And then right down through there's a bone that runs down the line here, and they come back out right between his eyes. And then when you pull this tight, it'll take that hook and snug everything up in it. Then I like to run 2 half-hitches just to help hold that bait on through the bites. The nice thing about these squid versus a smelt or a sand shrimp or something like that is they'll stay on here for a lot longer. All right, let's see if I can get one on before we get all the rods out. As you're dropping it down, you can kind of feel it clunk the bottom. After it hits the bottom, I like to kind of give it a couple good pulls, make sure that my line's nice and tight, make sure that I can feel that bottom and the weight's holding it down. Really important, I can't stress enough how important it is to keep this bait steady on the bottom.
So right here we have the Oregon Tackle Sturgeon Leader. It comes with a slider on it, you just hook your weight right to it, real simple. TB, we've got a scent chamber in here. We'll put a little bit of bloody tuna. Think about throwing some scent down here. Give it a little shake there, stick it in that hole. Look at that, fills right up. The thing about fishing these sturgeon and getting scent in the water is when you first get here, it might take a little bit for them to start to bite, but once you get that scent going down the river, all the fish will attract to that. So it's really important to have some good stinky stuff down there. So this rod here is the new Lima Glass. It's they call it the Super Jig Rod. And it's a glass rod. The thing about this, that Lima Glass sent it out with me today to hook some sturgeon. We're really gonna put it to the test. I mean, these are big fish. Typically on these glass rods back in the old days, The butt down here had to be about that big around to handle these sturgeon. This rod here is a 12 to 30. And the unique thing about them, they got a really good parabolic line to them. They're double-seated eyes all the way up until you get up into here. And then it goes to the single. But what I was impressed with is if you get a lot of guys on the boat and they're not sure what they're doing and they get a rod bent like that, it's going to break. These rods are real forgiving. You can really lay into them, and we're going to put it to the test here. We've got a few rods out now. We'll get these other two out, and we're going to hook some sturgeon and reef on them hard. So this is another rod we're using. We're going to be testing today, and this is a new Limaglass Super G. It's a glass rod. This one here is a 10 to 25. The double eyes all the way up, just a real strong. I tested this at the Sportsman Show this weekend, and you can really reef back on them, and I don't think you can snap them. They're just super, like it says, super G, super strong. Stick it in there, fill that scent chamber up. Get some smell on the water, get some scent flowing down the water, and these fish will just start gravitating upstream towards that.
Welcome back to the Willamette River. I'm Justin Wolf. We're establishing our scent trail and getting some bites, so it shouldn't be long now.
Sometimes these fish are real sensitive. When you pull these rods out, you want to come out super slow and don't let them feel it. Okay? Then I like to let him, okay, he's biting. So I'll reel down on him. And they'll chew on it for a little bit. So I don't just normally just set the hook as soon as I get a bite. I'll let them chew on it a little bit until I feel a really good hit. I think we've been fishing for 5 minutes now. We just got four rods in the water.
Let's get some fish.
Look
at
this.
Oh, yeah.
Now he's getting a little more aggressive.
So we've got a ton of fish down below us here. Doug's got one that's kind of chewing on his bait a little bit, waiting for it to get aggressive and really start biting down on it. He's holding it nice and straight, so as it gives it a good tug down like that, he's going to have lots of room to set back on that hook. I've got kind of a thick little lip on him, so it takes a little bit to get that hook to go through there. You still biting, Doug? Nibbling there?
Oh, he's nibbling a little bit. There's all kinds of different sizes of fish down here, all the way from a little 14 inches all the way up to 5 footers. Typically you get a smaller one, he might just nibble it on a little bit. But over the years I found that, I've caught some of the biggest fish that on a super soft bite. So that's the fun thing out here. You just never know what you're gonna hook up into.
That's for sure. So Doug, do you notice with the tide change and stuff like that on these fish that it kind of affects the bite a little bit?
Well, you got a little bite going on here too. Got two bites going, but yeah. I find that with salmon or sturgeon, depending on what the tide's doing, a lot of times at a high slack or a low slack, the bite will really turn on. With sturgeon, you want that current actually flowing though to get that scent flowing in the water. So not so much tide sensitive with them, I don't think, as much as it is other fish.
It double bites. As we fish for these a little bit and we get our scent out in the water, bite will actually increase. Oh, I think I got him. Oh, yeah.
There's a fish.
Oh, he just popped in.
Yeah. He's off. Awesome.
He was there for a second.
No fish.
Not yet, guys. Don't get
no
scared.
Fish. It will happen. That one looks pretty serious there, buddy.
Okay. He's biting down. Here we go. We're going to set on this guy. Give another little hook like that. Here you go, Dmitry. Fish.
Whoa.
Huh?
Woohoo!
Yeah!
Yeah, buddy.
Amazing. Oh! No, no.
Still there? Okay. Let me check that drag for you real quick. Is it okay?
It's okay.
Yeah, good, good. Try to keep them off this side of off the motor, okay? Turn this way. Now this is Dmitry. We went on a trip to Russia with Dmitry in August, and he's been to the States a few times, but this is his very first sturgeon. Looks like a nice one.
Unbelievable.
Yeah?
Yeah.
They got a lot of power.
Oh,
oh
yeah.
Look at that. Yeah, it is. Nice. Here, start walking back. Walk back.
My feels too good.
That's a good one. How's that feel?
Yes.
Good one, huh?
Good feel.
So it's all barbless hooks here. We're really not doing any harm to this fish. You can tell by his white belly and the scutes on the side how they're real sharp and on the back that this is a real healthy Willamette fish. This is what we want to see to get our fishery open back up.
Take your photo.
Yeah, get a photo.
Yes. How about that, buddy?
There you go.
Oh. Your first sturgeon.
No sturgeon.
Okay, head first, right in the water.
Dmitry Karmanov of Kahem Boats in Krasnoyarsk, Russia, has just landed his first sturgeon. But the Willamette River is closed to retention, so all fish must be released.
Flash. Oh,
he's there.
Got Paul. The fish.
So, Paul, I want you to fight that fish right off this side. Point your tip towards that ship. Position.
Maybe.
Very nice.
That's my karma. I always cut these kind of small babies.
So let's just take a couple steps back and I'll reach down and pull them out of the water by hand.
Okay.
Just try not to lift them by the rod itself.
Take a minute.
Again, barbless hooks on these guys, so we're not hurting them a bit. That's another real good, healthy young fish. Nice white belly, the scutes on it. When I'm saying scutes, I mean these things on the back, the razors, as some people call them. Real sharp. Nice white belly. These are good, healthy fish.
Okay, this is a Super G right here. Nice little bite on it.
Can I cut through here? Oh, there we go. That's a good feeling fish. Have at him there, buddy. Get you tipped down a little bit. There you go. Good job.
Oh, grab that one right there.
That one's on there. That's a good fish. Small one? Okay.
No.
Oh, yeah. Stay.
That one woke up.
Oh, same.
Then back up.
Good fish.
And here goes the double. There it is.
There he is.
All right, here's the very first one I've caught on this G rod right here. Super G by Lima Glass. So no problem. He's taking this thing down. I'm pulling on it. Look at that. Just as hard as I can pull on it. Look at the bend in that rod. Wow.
Another nice healthy fish on the Willamette River. See you later, buddy.
Is it rare to see a healthy fish here?
No, they've all been pretty healthy. Occasionally we'll get one that has a couple of little tumors or something on it, but for the most part they're coming back real strong. Feel there?
Yeah. And I'm pulling on. Look at that. I'm putting everything in.
Reel down,
right,
reel
here.
Down, reel.
You got a double going?
I think so. Is he there?
Oh, look at that. He's just ripping line out.
Oh, yeah, you got him.
Very nice. I'm pulling back on this rod as hard as I can right now without busting the line. And he's just still stripping line out.
Oh, we got a good one, don't we?
Wow, look at
this
rod.
Boy, the bend in that rod is just amazing, isn't it?
It's just handling this fish, man. Or is a fish handling me? I'm not sure.
We're getting into this one here.
So, I tried to snag a fish, ended up having no fish.
Look at that. I am just reefing straight down.
So that needs to
and I've got my thumb on the reel, so he can't run. So, I mean, I'm letting him pull everything he can on this rod. And it's just incredible how this thing's holding up. These things are just so much fun to catch. I mean, they're just, look at that, they're just fighters.
Yeah, they're fighters.
They're fighters,
yes.
This water's warmed up. It's about 47 degrees, so it puts these things on the bite a little bit better. We're just kind of coming out of the winter months. Things are starting to warm up. A few guys down below with some springers. Now see those bubbles in the water? Typically when you see that, they're done. This fish should probably come right up now. Let's just see. There he is, a monster. Whoa.
Welcome back to the Willamette River. I'm Justin Wolf. We have all four rods out and all four have been busy with big, healthy Willamette River sturgeon.
There he is, a monster.
Big one.
Wow.
Still down.
Right here on the Super G.
Are we gonna pull? You guys wanna see him? Let's roll him over here on his belly. Get him up on top of the water. Man, that's a beautiful fish.
Isn't that a nice one?
That's a beautiful fish. There we go. Left tail.
There we go.
Nice and easy on him.
That's a nice fish.
Boy, that's a dandy there. Oh, look at that guy.
That's a big one.
Right on. That's beautiful.
On this new glass rod, I'll tell you what. And I tried to break this thing. I mean, I was leaning into it with everything I had.
I never heard it make a noise. It was a great rod. That's amazing. Look at that fish. Boy.
Yeah.
Thanks for the fun. Go back and make some babies for us. Gotta love that.
Well, now that we've got some scent in the water, it's been nonstop action. I mean, it's... We got all the rods in now just because everyone's been getting hit. We just landed a nice 6-foot fish and now we're reeling on another one here. Like I said, once that scent gets flown in the water, the action stays picked up pretty quick.
Another good healthy fish. Here in Oregon, we've had a decline on our sturgeon population. So the Department of Fish and Wildlife and the fisheries have decided that they wanted to close everything down to catch and release. Even though we're catching these, we're hooking doubles and triples, they manage the fishery so well that they noticed the population going down, so they took charge and tried to do something about it. So let's hope here in the next couple of years, we're able to keep a couple of these a piece a year. Go with this original formula. So we're using Oregon Tackle's leaders here. They're a sturgeon leader. They're tied up with the slider already on it. And then this one we attached a scent chamber to. And we're using some original formula scent chamber magic here. You just get it inside this hole and give it a squeeze and it fills that up. And there's a bead there at the bottom and it'll slowly release that liquid out. Keep a nice scent trail going all day for you. Lots of action. Great for little kids, too.
Yeah.
Told you, this is my karma.
Ain't cut any bigger than that.
Really?
Yeah.
We're going to have to fix that today.
Oh, yes.
What a wiggly one.
Oh, yeah.
Your karma.
That's my karma.
Nice. Oh yeah, that's the one I wanted to see hook up there. Look at the bend in that rod.
Oh yeah.
Bump, bump, bump. Oh, very nice. That's a nice fish for that. I can't believe that little rod held up like that. That's amazing. Look at the bend in that thing. That's a great looking fish. Very nice.
Beautiful fish.
Reel down a little bit. This is the only rod left in the water. We've had three fish on all the other ones. Just non-stop action all day long. There he is.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's a nice fish there.
Looks like we got a double going here, too. Got one just hooked up on the other side.
Paul, this is what you're looking for here.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Okay. We got another one going there too.
You guys are pretty fresh. Here we go.
That one's biting too.
Well, just let that one go. Got that one there. Got a bite here.
Healthy fish. I know I've said it a million times, but it sure is nice to see these fish looking so good. So the hook I'm using here is a Gamagatsu Big River. These hooks, I've never broken one. I've never had one straighten out on me. And we've hooked and had up to the side of the boat fish up to about 8, 10 feet.
Okay, over the side.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.